Hey guys, I'm back again and this is Drawing and Painting lesson number 2. I'm very excited as always, and today I will tell you the forms of painting and drawing and the instruments which you can use in drawing. They are so different. There are so many kind of instruments you can use, and I'll show you some of them. So, starting with instruments, there are graphite pencils, pens and ink. For example, I don't know if this one is used for drawing, but I think why not? Okay, I'm sure how does it look from the side. So, this is pen and inks. We all know how inks looks like. Oh, this is my printer. So, anyways. I used it before in painting. Graphite pencils, pens and ink, wax color pencils. I don't have wax color pencils, but if I just fold them, I let you sort of see them. And pastels. So this is, for example, it's big pastel. I don't know if you can see this. So. Eye pastels. I think I've seen this before. It's over. And this is how it looks like inside. So, pastels, there are oil and soft pastels. I'm having oil pastels. Soft are a little more expensive than oil pastels. And various kinds of erasers. So I'm having these types of erasers, this one, and this one over here. It's just like a pen. And you can see this. This is the eraser. It helps me a lot because it's so little and you can just erase so little parts. And because this one it can do the same part as this one. And this is the erasers that you can put inside on that. Okay. So this is the eraser, and you just have to put it inside this thing. So these were some types of erasers, and then you have the markers. Well, markers, there are so many types of markers, and having this one, for example, I use this for illustrating my pictures and the things that I drew, my paints, all that stuff. This one is a Staedtler, it's permanent. And this one is Faber Castell. Well, really, actually, the same, I think. But I prefer the Staedtler one. Pencils, and well, pencils, there are two types. The pencil which kind of like it's not colored and it's black and white, and the colored pencils. Well, that's all the things I have. So, going into the forms of painting. So, forms of painting are numerous, but I'm going to talk about five forms, which are at first. The first form is drawing. So, what actually drawing is? So, drawing is a sort of visual art in which you can use various drawing instruments, as the ones that I've showed you just now. So, for example, to make it more simpler, it's something which you can draw and we all have the same opinion about it. For example, when you draw a bird and you just show it to your friend and ask them, what the hell are you seeing? So, they will all agree that it's a bird. And this is what I call a draw. This is drawing. And the second type is gesture. As in gesture painting. Well, what is gesture? It's a style of painting in which paint is spontaneously dribbled, splashed, or smeared onto the canvas. I'll show you some examples in this video. So it's splashed onto the canvas rather than being carefully applied. So you're not doing it in a careful way. You're just splashing the colors all over the canvas and making some sort of paint, which is called gesture. The third form is composition. So, composition is the placement or arrangement of visual elements or ingredients in a work of art. So this is composition. Third form is narration, as a narrative art. What is this? It's an art that tells a story. So it tells a story either at the moment, in an ongoing story, or as a sequence of events unfolding over time. So this is narration or narrative art. I told you before, it's the art that tells the story. And lastly, abstraction as an abstract art. Well, it uses a visual language of shape, form, color, and line to create a composition, which may exist in the real world or may not exist, with a degree of independence from visual references in the world. So I don't know if you watched the first lesson or not, but if you haven't, be sure to check it out. You'll find it here, over here, up here. Yeah, and well, in the first lesson, I've drawn this picture for Michael from Monster Inc. because this is one of my favorite Disney cartoons. And I decided to make it in the first lesson because I love it so, so much. So, in this lesson, I'm going to paint it. It's not hard and so easy. We are going to make it in a shaded way. I mean, we want to make it just like 3D as long as we can. I'm still learning, as I've told you before in the first lesson, and we can learn this together. So I'm using my Staedtler color pencils and starting by Mr. Michael over there. So grabbing all your green colors, even if you're not going to use all of them, just let them be there beside you. You'll feel more comfortable with yours. So, if you're imagining that the sun is coming from up here, so that means that the shadow is going to be down here. So, you are going to make it from starting from the lighter green to the darker green. So that's easy, isn't it? You just have to imagine from where comes the light, and when you just imagine this, you will know where goes the shadow. As if you can see this is my hand's shadow because the lamp is over there. So this is how drawing just go on. It's so easy, as I've told you before. So I'll start painting with my light green. That's okay if it's first time it feels it's not the perfect painting, but you'll get used to it by practicing. Practicing is the key of learning. As much as you practice, as much as you'll be more influenced and more used of the things you are learning. So I'm going to make it as
a little bit curvy because he is he seems to be like a ball, so to make it more effective you just don't have to just go it on straight lines. You do it in a curvy way. I don't know, it won't take a while. Maybe I don't want to speed up the video because it's a lesson, so we don't have to speed up the lessons. Oh, it seems cute. Maybe we will start a little bit shading his eyes. I don't know, can you see this? Cool, isn't it? See? It looks perfect. And this is how things would go on with it. See how it goes? It doesn't feel any difference, you know? It's just like it's a river of colors going on together from the darker to the right to the lighter green. You don't feel any difference. I thought we were done with Mr. Mikey. Then the cloud, you are just going to use some gray, and just that. For some shadows, you'll see this. Yeah. And just that. This is for the cloud. And then as you can see here, I've drawn the door of the company. So I'm just going to illustrate it. See? It's so easy. So I'm going to repeat that all over the door. It doesn't matter now. Grab this yellow. 3. So, you're not going to complete the rest of the company because it's going to go on with the same pattern, but I'm going to paint the sky. So, you can just make this all the same when I'm done with it. I'll show you how it looks like. So, I've just colored the rest of it, the things that... Oh, the endless windows. That would take forever. Yeah, it took a long time for me to just complete this. But, and... That's all. thanks guys for watching this video, lesson number 2 in drawing and painting. And if you haven't yet watched lesson number 1, don't forget to check the description below, and I put a link for the first lesson. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, and a thumbs down if you don't. And don't forget to subscribe to Create With Us and Play With Us, our other channel, on which you will find gaming videos, PC tutorials, and phone tutorials. So, thanks guys for watching. See you in the next video. Bye!